Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, helping you make home and hospitality simple. This is my laundry room. It's a walk-in laundry room, which I am grateful for. In this video, I'm going to show you how I've organized it and specifically for my cleaning supplies. With the things that have been happening, I've always had cleaning supplies stocked up because we do have three bathrooms. My husband has a Pilates studio, so I have to have things at the ready. So I do have toilet paper, I have Kleenex, I have cleaning supplies, I have paper towels. So I'm going to show you where I've stocked those. Think about the vertical space. Maybe if you have even a laundry closet, there are vertical spaces on the side. And then also look at any behind the door where you could put these shoe holders. They're very versatile. They don't take up a lot of space and they hold a lot. I've already done a tour of my laundry room before, but I'm gonna focus more on how I've stored things. So here, of course, I have a clock. I have our Dyson, which is amazing. I try to keep this area open. Now there's a extension cord because it goes out here to our shredder because that is where my mail system is. And then these were here when we moved here. So I had thought about if I took all of this out, I could definitely have more space because I can have shelves going along the whole length of the wall. But for now, I didn't want to spend any money, so I kept these. And then I had painted these white. These were undone. So here on the left, I have laundry detergent, and I usually buy from Amazon now. Sometimes we buy from Costco. Okay, I do have a studio light in here just to film this because it's not the brightest room. I do have a lamp here on the side that adds a little extra light, and I like to have it on at night when I'm in here. I have this little tray that I got on clearance from Target, and then we just keep the cup holder here. Here's one more pod that was from another one like that that we're almost done with. And then when you open this up, this is where I keep toilet paper. And so obviously some have been used already, and I do have toilet paper holders in each bathroom. So those are good for a week, I believe. Okay, and then I have here some tissues. So I order those now from Amazon. I used to get them from Costco, but it's just a lot easier to not brave the waves at Costco and just have them delivered to my home from Amazon. And then this container has a cover, and then this is where we put bar soap. So you can see that we've used up some of the Kleenex. This is usually filled up. Now, again, if this space was more in, you could use the inside of cabinets to hold more things. You might have Bounce or dryer balls or even Epsom salt or things that in your mind are cleaning or spa or toiletries. Look at the vertical space. So another space to look at for organizing if you're low on space is to look at above the door. I'm sure you've seen those before. You just put a shelf across there and you can stack different toilet paper or paper towels or things like that. You can even put it along here, okay, all the way around. So you see there's a lot of space. And if I wanted to add one more of these, I could put it here and I could put it here. Now, it may not be the prettiest thing, but it's going to be functional. Now, a lot of you may have a laundry room closet, and usually they have these basic wire shelving. I actually added these. So imagine before I just had that cabinet and I didn't have anything here. It's a lot of wasted space. So I went ahead and put the wire shelf. These bins are from Target. This is for lint. And then I have dryer balls in here. And luckily I do a once a year shopping at Bath and Body Works. So we have a bunch of those small hand sanitizers here. Okay. And then we were given a bunch of Epsom salt at my husband's studio. So we have that, and those do come in handy. And then I have disposable gloves here. I do a lot of potlucks for our church, so I just have that there, and I bring a bunch, or I bring a whole box for when we serve. And then I have way too many bags. These have multiplied in the last couple months because it's citrus season here, and people have been giving us lots of citrus and giving us our bags and not wanting them back. So I'm at my limit now because everything, if it doesn't fit in the bin, then it has to go. So having a bin limits the space you're allotting for a certain type of item, so you don't have to be over cluttered, right?
Okay, here I just have our laundry basket for darks and lights, and each one of our family members, we do our own laundry. I actually have some laundry in here now. Here's our dryer. Oh yeah, I forgot to show. These are baskets I believe I got from HomeGoods. These hold accessories for our Dyson, and then these are paper towel holders. So four paper towels can fit in each basket. So once those start getting low, you can see this is a little bit, I think I have one left in there. And then I believe I have four left in there. So we still have enough. All right, behind the door, this is where I keep my overflow foil and parchment paper, Ziploc bags, other cleaning supplies. And then these are ones that clean grout. And actually, this one too is painting grout. So I'll be doing that project probably this coming week. And then some more cleaning supplies. We have a fire extinguisher there, the mop heads for our mop, larger bleach that didn't fit in those pockets. And then for my cleaning tools like brooms and mops, I put them here. Right now it's a lot of brooms. And then here I have SOS pads. Now I never buy Clorox, okay? I never buy them. And we went and got some stuff at my son's place because he's in university, so he moved back in while school is online, and I had happened to buy him Clorox or Lysol. Now, why I bought him Lysol, maybe I thought he just needed the stronger stuff, but luckily we have a little supply now, and I got some of the Lysol spray. These are the Walmart generic brand, a bunch of bleach, some extra shampoo there, and then I happened to find these at Walmart. Okay, over here are some more wipes and liquid hand soap. So these are things that are needed in my husband's off studio. Some more cleaning supplies. So underneath each bathroom sink, I have a caddy for all the cleaning supplies for the bathroom. So these are definitely ones that are for backup, right? In stock. And those are toilet bowl cleaners, soft scrub. Okay, and then these, this one I really like. I don't know if you've ever tried these from Target or Mrs. Meyers. Tub and Tile, they really work at getting the scum off of the sides of the bathtub or the bathroom, bathtub walls or the shower walls. Okay, and then got some Palmolive. So what I do is I grab this and I pour it into the dispenser that I have in the kitchen, and then I bring this back and put it here. So instead of putting it under the sink. All right, let me know in the comments below where you store your cleaning supplies. Is it under different sinks? Is it in a specified closet? Is it hanging off your walls like mine are? I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. All this time you thought we'd never pay the price.